Hello, welcome to this story for Children's Church at Christ Church Lancaster. Now this is a really special story, so let's take a moment just to be still and to get ready. Now this is a story that might be about you or someone you know, but this is a story about baptism. Now in baptism, we baptize people in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. God, who is our Creator, Redeemer, and our Sustainer. Now this is water. With it we remember the waters the flood, the waters that God's people walked through on their journey to the promised land, the water that Jesus himself was baptized in, the water that you might have been or will be baptized in. Now, there was once a man who said some amazing things and did some wonderful deeds. And wherever he went, people would ask him, "Who are you?" And one day, when they asked him, he said, "I am the light." Now the Holy Spirit goes where it wills. It rides on the invisible wind like a dove. It brings comfort and power. And like the scent of this oil, it is invisible. The smell fills the room. It's invisible, but it is there. Now, when someone comes for baptism, we ask them questions. And sometimes, if they're not old enough to answer for themselves, we ask their parents and godparents. And then we are ready. But wait, names are important. What name shall we give to this person? How about Mary? Mary, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And Mary, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever. Amen. And this is the day when Mary receives her light. And we light it from the Christ candle. So Mary, receive your light. And if you have been christened or baptized, you would have received a light too. So this would be my light. Now look, see how the light has grown, filling up the room. But the first light burns just as brightly, even now it has been shared. I wonder how much light could come from this one light. But look, let me show you something. I'm going to change the light. I didn't say blow it out. I'm going to change it. If you watch, I'll show you with mine first. Light goes out, invisible all across the room. Just because you can't see it here anymore doesn't mean that it's not filling this room with light. Anywhere you go, that light will be with you. See it or whether it has been changed. And the room is full of invisible light. And that light is your light. The light you received at your baptism, at your christening. You maybe have your own christening candle at home. You might want to light it as a reminder that Christ's light shines with you. And even as life changes around you, that invisible light is still all around you and within you. I wonder, what part of that story did you like the best? I wonder if there was any bit of that story that we could take out and still have all the story we needed. I wonder, what is the most important bit of the story? Those are big questions, and you might want to take a while to think about them. Perhaps if you're drawing or colouring or sculpting or making, you will be able to tell that story in your own way too. wonder for yourself about what this story might mean.